Good day to all of you. Myself, Dr. Arvind Sharma, Associate Professor in Physics, Government Dugar College, Bikaner. Today is our MSc previous topic is Reflection and Transmission at Steps and Distances. You are already understand these topics in your UG 13 class. So I search a better article than a book. That article is given by Flexible Learning Approach to Physics, module P11.1. And this module is Reflection and Transmission at Steps and Barriers. That means potential step and rectangular potential barrier problem is discussed in a very interesting and in a different approach. If you read this article, you think about that you are going to learn many things. Okay, so first of all, given opening items, module introduction, fast track questions, ready to start. That is the way to study in a better way. Number two, reflection and transmission at potential step when E greater than V. Number three, when E less than V. Number four, reflection and transmission at a barrier when E less than V. Okay. And number five, some summary and achievements and exit test. Okay. So let us start. Opening items, you just read it. Okay. Study comment, fast track question. The question you can understand is this article. Number one, a stationary question F1, a stationary state spatial wave function psi x equal to a psi a exponential iota kx represents a stream of particles. What is this? This is a stream of particles. What is the number density of particles per unit length, momentum of each particle and conflux? Question F2 and question F3, you can easily understand after going through this article. Ready to study? Here, what we want to study, okay, that is given question R1 and R2, R3, R4. So, our aim to understand the conceptual base of potential step. Reflection and transmission at a potential step when E greater than V. Okay. According to classical mechanics, the potential energy function Ux and X is shown by if fx equal to minus dux upon dx. Okay, classical description. When physical situation, a particle is moving with constant velocity in the positive x direction and encounters at some point a strong force directed in the negative x direction. The force is constant in time and acts over a distance d. Okay. According to classical Newtonian mechanics, with a potential energy function Ux, F equal to minus dUx upon dx, conservative force, you know about that. Okay. The potential energy functions looks like the figure 1. Okay. This is V. Ux equal to 0 when x less than 0 and Ux equal to V when x greater than or equal to g. Okay. For obvious reason, the situation is referred to potential state, like a potential state. What is explanation of classical mechanics? classical mechanics, in classical mechanics, initial speed of particle and mass m and the potential energy, if u is velocity, then kinetic energy is half mu square plus v, because it approaches to the straight, and if we let small v be the speed beyond the straight, that means initial kinetic energy is half mu square and potential energy is zero. But after interacting with straight, kinetic energy becomes half mv square and potential energy is zero. That means v equal to under root 2 v minus v. This equation has a real solution if e greater than v or equal to. The particle then passes across the strip and continues with reduced speed. If potential energy has a value greater than E beyond the strip, then the solution for V is purely imaginary and does not represent a physical situation. If E less than V, then you easily understand from this equation that V becomes imaginary. Okay? So, this is not a physical, real situation. In fact, the particle is reflected from the strip and is not seen in the region x greater than or equal to 2. So, what we understand from this, in the classical sense, reflected means that repulsive force is so strong that the particle comes to rest and then moves back in the direction from which it came. Okay, this is the argument given from the classical concepts. This is a question you can easily understand. Now, what is your model for quantum mechanics? So, our model is like potential strip, figure 2. Okay, initially x less than 0. Potential is 0, but x greater than or equal to 0, its constant value v. Okay? So, this is shown in this figure. Region 1 is x less than 0 and region 2 is x greater than or equal to 0. On x-axis, ux, and on y-axis versus x, ux versus x is shown here. Okay, particle transmitted across the strip if E greater than V. That is classical mechanics approach. Classical mechanics shows that E greater than V, V greater than 0. Okay, that means particle transmitted across the strip. Particle reflected if E less than V, V greater than 0. Particle always transmitted across strip if V less than or equal to 0. So, three cases are given here according to classical mechanics. Now, if you want to know about the solution, that what quantum mechanics gives the interpretation of such kind of problem. The time-independent Schrödinger equation and its solutions for a potential strip. The strip is given, as we already seen in classical mechanics approach, same x less than 0. This is region u equal to 0, and for x greater than or equal to d, this is v. In your book, this symbol is taken as capital V, so there is no problem. Symbols can be taken in any kind of way. Okay, in quantum mechanics we generally take the potential with V. Okay, in your book U is V and V is V. Okay, now what we want to do, what quantum mechanics can tell us about a physical situation. Okay, we have to make a simple model and then solve the Schrödinger equation to find the appropriate wave function. What is your aim? we just solve the Schrodinger equation. First, we write the Schrodinger equation for the regions where particle existence, and then we solve it for wave. In classical mechanics, we model the potential function as a step and make the approximation that d is small but small compared with what. Okay? So the relevant dimensions is now d Broglie wavelength of the incident particle. Lambda equal to h upon p. Particle's momentum initial. The potential energy diagram is shown. There are two regions, 1 and 2, and Schrodinger equation is given by minus h bar square upon 2m d2 psi x upon dx2 plus ux psi x equal to e psi x. Where e is the total energy of the particle, ux is the potential energy, and psi x the spatial part of the wave function. Study current. The full wave function is time dependent and satisfy the time dependent Schrodinger equation is written for stationary state. For definite energy, the wave function have the form psi x t equal to psi x e raised to minus iota e t upon h. Since this module is entirely concerned with the states of given energy E, we need only to determine psi x, which may therefore conveniently refer to as wave function. The full wave function follows immediately. Okay? So we are taking only x component Schrodinger equation, that is time independent Schrodinger equation, one dimensional Schrodinger equation. And after that you can take multiplication with time component. Okay? So region 1, ux equal to 0, psi x equal to psi 1x. Okay, so for region 1, minus h bar square upon 2m d2 psi 1x upon dx2 equal to e psi 1x. The solution of this equation is given as, because this equation is similar as simple harmonic motion, k1 equal to under root 2m upon h cross square, then this equation becomes d2 psi 1x upon dx2 equal plus k1 square psi 1x equal to 0. And solution is like that, exponential iota kx, and general solution is given by psi 1x equal to a e ki power a exponential iota k1x plus b exponential minus iota k1x. First term gives the incident wave and second term gives the reflected wave at the step x equal to 0. In region 2, ux equal to v, Schrodinger equation is given by e minus v psi 2x, and psi is replaced by psi 2. And solution has similarly general solution psi 2x equal to c exponential iota k2x plus d exponential minus iota k2x, where c and d are arbitrary complex conjugate, and k2 equal to under root 2m e minus v. Okay. Now, the argument I already given, that in first equation psi 1x, first term shown the particle moving from left side, that means incident wave, and this is reflected. Okay, because h cross k1 is incident and minus h cross k1 is reflected. And in equation 3, h cross k2 is given incident wave, but clearly there is no boundary for reflection, so we must take d equal to 0. Okay, because there is no term, there is no hurdle, or there is no thing is there that reflect the wave, so d equal to 0, since the physical problem involves particle approaching the barrier from left and not from the right, and here it cannot be written from infinity. Okay. Now, in summary, what we do for region 1 and 2, we solve the Schrodinger equation psi 1x equal to a exponential iota k1x plus b exponential minus iota k1x. Region 1, and psi t equal to say c exponential iota k 2x. Four is 2. A, B, C are constants which can be determined by using the boundary conditions for the two relations. Relations imposed by the boundary conditions. We know that at boundaries x equal to 0, both V function and its gradient should be continuous. That means psi 1x equal to psi 2x, psi 1x equal to psi 2x, and d psi 1x upon x, dx equal to d psi 2x upon x equal to x. Okay? The first condition ensures that the wave function has a single value x equal to 0. Born probability hypothesis. So, using these two boundary conditions for equation 1 and for equation 2. This is equation 1. Okay. What we see here, if both E and Ux are finite quantities, then second derivative must be also finite. If E and U are finite, then second derivative of it should be finite. First derivative of wave function cannot suddenly change at any point, including x equal to 0. Therefore, the slope of wave function in region 1 at x equal to 0 equal to slope of the wave function in region 2. That is continuous. What is the argument? First derivative cannot suddenly change at any point, including at boundary. So, there is continuity. Due to that, slope of wave function is region 1 at equal to 0 is equal to the slope of wave function in region 2 also at x equal to 0. What are the possibilities in figure 3? Okay. A shows a discontinuity at psi at x equal to 0. Because this is discontinuity, there is a stream. B has psi continuous, but d psi upon dx is discontinuous at x equal to 0. Shown in this. C, both C and d psi upon dx are continuous. Both psi and d psi upon dx are continuous. So for A, psi 1 not equal to psi x. Because discontinuity in psi. Okay. And in B, psi 1 equal to psi 2. But d psi 1 upon d psi 1 upon dx not equal to d psi 1 upon d psi 2 upon dx. But in this case, psi 1 equal to psi 2 and d psi 1 upon dx equal to d psi 1. So, you understand it clearly. Now, applying the boundary conditions. Psi 1 and psi 2. Equation 4. Psi 1 0 equal to psi 2 0. E plus B equal to C. And from equation number 2, that means x d psi 1 upon dx equal to d psi 2 upon dx when x equal to 0, then you get the this relation that can be easily done by. Okay, there are two equations, you just solve these algebraic equations for B in terms of A and C in terms of A. That is B in terms of A and C in terms of A. B by A and C by A. And there is a question. Now, the wave function is to each region and the physical interpretation normalization. Okay. In our discussion quantum mechanics, we have assumed that psi x is normalized. Psi x square del x gives the probability of finding the particle at x plus in the range x to x plus delta x. Now it is convenient to modify the prescription and say that wave function can represent more than one particle. Okay, can represent a set of particles moving in the x direction with the same momentum. With the same momentum, the position of any particle is not specified. To do so violates the Heisenberg uncertainty principle. So particle position is not specified, but we say that average number of particles per unit length is given by psi. In this context, average means the average of a large number of observations made on particles with wave function. Okay, the wave function psi x equal to a e raised to iota kx represents a stream of particles. Moving in the x direction. So on average, magnitude of a square particles per unit length. Okay, so it should be clear. Now, we already done two equations for region 1 and 2. These are the solutions. And the argument is that incident particles, reflected particles, first term incident, second term reflected. But here, there is no boundary for transmission. So, d equal to 0. Okay. The transmitted particles, the average number of transmitted particles per unit length is c square. Defining particle flux in the classical and quantum mechanics. What is particle flux? In classical mechanics, we know that the particle flux. What is particle flux? If there are n particles, per unit length, okay, and each one has speed u in positive x direction, then all the particles in a length u delta t will pass a fixed point in time interval delta t. So, number of passing a fixed point per unit time. Number passing a fixed point per unit time is the particle flux. What is this nu delta t upon delta t equal to nu? In quantum mechanics, what is particle flux? Because we are considering a stream of particle given by this average number of particles per unit length. Average number of particles per unit length is given by magnitude of t square, because p equal to h plus k and u equal to p upon n. That means u equal to h plus k upon n. For k greater than 0, so is u. The flux is given by f equal to a square h plus upon a. This is nothing but v p. What is v? V is velocity and p is probability of finding the particle. Wave function is a momentum wave function. Wave function is a momentum eigenfunction. When wave function is momentum eigenfunction, then momentum is then same for all particles. And the average number of particles per unit length is constant independent of position. Now, here in this article, different approach is given. Explanation is given also in between there. The article is same, potential step, and here reflection and transmission relations are derived. What is reflection coefficient? R equal to, what is R? Ratio of flux of reflected particles. Ratio of flux of reflected particles and flux of incident particles. psi 1 is given by that, and we know that in last article f equal to a square h cross k. That can be used directly. Okay. Now what is r? R is nothing but b square h cross k1 m upon a square h cross k1 m equal to b upon a square. And we derive b upon a in equation 7, just report the declaration given by k1 minus k2 upon k1 plus k2 square for e greater than v. And what is transmission coefficient? Flux of transmitted particles upon flux of incident particles. Now psi 2 equal to c exponential iota k2x, that means psi c square h cross k2 but m upon m is given by transmitted flux. So t is given by c square h cross k2 upon m upon a square h bar k1 upon m equal to c square magnitude of c square k2 upon magnitude of a square k1, and c upon a is derived in say 1, and this is given by t equal to 4 k1 k2 upon k1 plus k2 ka k1 plus k2 whole square for e greater than v. What we see that r plus t bar. Here is the relations for r and t, but what we can understand from here, that reflection approaches the limit r equal to 1 when transmission goes to 0, when k2 tending to 0, and this will happen when v is equal to incident particle energy e. Okay, px equal to psi x square probability density. That is, Px is particle density function. What is Px? Px is particle density function, and you can easily plot it like here, and after that it is constant. Because P1x equal to psi 1 star x, psi 1x equal to this, P1 star, and P2x equal to C star. A square plus B square plus twice AB cos 2K1X. P1X and P2 join smoothly at X power 0 because of the boundary A plus B power this and this. You clearly understand this figure. So in region 1, PX has cosine component. This is cosine component due to interference between incident and reflected. This example of quantum mechanical interference with material particles is analogous to the interference of light beams reflected from boundaries between materials with different optical properties. Okay, the interference minima are not at zero because the amplitude of reflected wave is less than the amplitude of the incident wave. Okay. A small question is given here. You can easily understand now the case E less than V. If E less than V, then what will happen? We can understand in this article. So we do it tomorrow or next lecture. So today we learn how E greater than V problem for potential state is explained and mathematically understood. Okay, thank you.